Ron Van Warmer, and Acoustic Breakfast is a very special one today. We are really excited to have some live music in the studio this morning. You know, every now and again, an album comes across my desk that I know is special. The first time I play it, it's rare, but it does happen. And that's just what happened when I put Luke Pruitt's Home Part 2 in the CD player in my car on the way home when I was driving home from the studio. And I couldn't stop listening to it. In fact, I had to take a detour and take a long way home so that I could finish the CD before I got there. And then I had to sit in the driveway while the last song ended before I could actually get out of the car so I could hear the whole thing. And as it turns out, that is exactly how you should listen to it. It's like in one listening in its entirety. And that, of course, was several months ago. But I set out then to try to persuade Luke to make his way to Woodstock so that we could do just that, listen to the song, the entire album. And this morning, Luke Pruitt and his band have joined us live here in the studio. And thank you for making the trip and welcome.
Thank you for having us. Thanks for welcoming us.
And the subject of this album is it's so relevant right now, even more so, actually, than when I first heard it. I've been playing it and talking about it here on the radio for some time for our listeners. But for those who might not know, can you tell us how you came up with the premise, first of a musical novella, and then, you know, the subject itself?
Right. Well, I had written an EP, Songs of Home Part 1, and there were a couple songs on there that I had kind of stuck with me, which I'll play both of those today. But one was a song called County Fair, and it was about this young kid who's learning the basics of the music business and
playing for tips at the county fair. And so I kind of took that character and I wanted to develop it a little bit more. And there was another song about some immigrants from Vietnam that were in my hometown, and so I wrote a song about them, and so that kind of spurred my interest in looking at my own hometown from two different points of view, and so that was kind of the beginning of it. I guess that was the kernel that sort of started the process on what became Songs of Home Part 2.
And then you interviewed some of the people that you wrote about.
Right.
And got their story and then wrote the songs based on that. And then each successive song sort of became another part of the story.
Right. You know, it's funny. I call it a novella album, and it kind of rolled out more like a sort of a collection of short stories or something like that. But whatever it was, I interviewed them, some friends of mine who are immigrants from Mexico and live in my hometown, and got their story. And I... So I ended up writing several songs that fit the album based on that.
And when I heard it, I wanted to hear something between the songs that completes the story. And that was when I thought, well, we've got to get Luke to come here and cool. Do that for us. So that's what I want you to do here this morning.
All
is
right.
Is play your music and tell your story, and the floor is yours.
Well, I appreciate it. I'm glad to be here. I think we all are. So I'm going to start with the County Fair, the song from my first record, and talk a little bit more about this character as we go along.
I'm gonna take my guitar down to the county fair, play among the bells chime and the people passing by. Smell of funnel cake in the August air, my guitar case open wide, and I'm playing down at the county fair tonight. Gravel ain't too rocky at the tarot lady's. Foot traffic steady, she always treats me nice. She tells me that I'm wise beyond my youth. Oh, door, she says my future's bright, and I'm playing down at the county fair tonight. Hey mister, got a dollar, I got a tune, any old pocket change will do. Well, I'm saving all I can, gonna leave this town when I graduate in June. Hey mister, got a dollar, I can sometimes bum a cigarette from old Paul selling beer. He rolls his own and tries to teach me how to make it tight. He says music ain't been good in 50 years. Well, I guess he may be right, but I'm playing down at the county fair tonight. Hey mister, got a dollar? Change to do. Well, I'm saving all I can. Gonna leave this town when I graduate in June. Hey mister, got a dollar, I got a tune. Hey mister, got a dollar. Got a dollar, I got a tune. Hey mister, got a dollar, I got a tune. La da la da la da 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 la da da da. Hey mister, got a dollar, I got a tune.
So that's sort of where the story begins there.
Yeah.
So I wanted to develop that develop that character and take him into the next record. That's kind of where the idea for the record started. And so so this song came out of that. This is kind of a continuation of that story. It's just sort of this in-between time where this kid knows he's going to leave home soon, but hasn't yet. And I brought the tarot lady back into this song as well. And maybe my favorite moment as a songwriter is that I got to steal a line from Dr. Seuss on this song. This is called Bless the Wind.
Baseball in her streets, war games in her neighborhoods, I built houses in her trees. But my childhood games I played, dreamt my childhood dreams. One more school year left to go, and I'll be free to roam. The highway's on the horizon, as far as I can see. So I asked the tarot lady where the wind could carry me. She had gypsy eyes, mystical and wise. She turned her cards and took my hand and said to me, oh, she said, bless the winds that carry us into the unknown. May experience make us wise, may our wisdom grow. Oh, and wherever you go, be kind to a stranger. Wherever you go, may a stranger be kind to you. Wherever you go, seek only truth. And bless the winds that carry us into the unknown. And may experience make us wise, and may our wisdom grow. Oh, and oh, the places, oh, the places you'll go.
So that's where Songs of Home Part 2 begins,
with that young millennial.
And I was living in, I'm from Fort Smith, Arkansas, and lived there and wrote this album there. And I had some friends that are immigrants from Mexico, and I knew I wanted to sort of look at my hometown through more eyes than just the young millennial kid. And so I interviewed them a couple times, and I could tell it's kind of awkward doing interviews. I'm not real experienced with them. It was kind of new to me, and I didn't really know what I wanted to get out of it. And I could tell one of the brothers who I was interviewing, till he didn't really know what to think of it either, and he kind of looked at me, and he said, you know, I see in the news, and I see how angry people are, and how poorly we can be represented in the media sometimes. And he said, I don't know what you're going to do with these songs, but I hope through them that you can show our roots. And so I ended up with a few songs out of that interview, and this is the first one. And this is Their Roots. It's called Coyote.
Summer, when the heat was insane, Mother called me La Luz del Sol, but David is my Christian name. The firstborn of two, my brother is Felix, a father a carpenter with nothing to fix. And our bellies were small, we slept on the floor. Long and cranky with a Guadalajara knife. Our mother died when I was just 9. She was young, but her heart was not strong. And our bellies were small. Papa was sad, and he drank through his sorrow in a Guadalajara night. Oh, but tia Rosita, mi padres hermanas, knew a boy had no place in a Guadalajara. When I was 17, she found a way, and I said goodbye to the Guadalajara nights. Coyote, 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 yeah, take me away to the land of the labor. I labor the rest of Coyote, 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 yeah, take me away. A un nuevo hogar, un asilo, coyote, take me away. Say that Felix was stabbed in the Guadalajara night, and it's only by God he's still alive, just a boy of 15 in the Guadalajara night. Coyote, 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 yeah, take me away to the land of the labor. I labor the rest of my day. Coyote, 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 yeah, take me away. A un nuevo hogar, un asilo, coyote, take me away. A un nuevo hogar, un asilo, coyote, take me away.
It's Acoustic Breakfast on Radio Woodstock 100.1. Live in the studio, performing with us is Luke Pruitt. His band is here. Luke, would you like to introduce your band? Well,
I would. I had a band booked for this. Part of it came from Fayetteville, Arkansas. Part of it came from Nashville, Tennessee, and they both bailed on me at fairly short notice. And so on drums over here is Caleb Dollister, and Caleb lives in New York City now, and I used to play with Caleb back in years ago in Nashville. It had been a while since we played together, and so I called Caleb, and he was able to do it. And I felt confident he could get the material learned, and he called Sam Trapjack.
Old friends.
Yeah, right.
New Sam, friends.
So Sam and I just met recently, so we're just kind of figuring this out. But these guys are great. I'm I'm jealous of musicians who can do things like that that quickly, because I'm not one of them. But,
yeah, me too. That last song you did, Coyote, is the one that grabbed me when I was listening to the album and made me continue to listen to the rest of it. And that's the song I kept going back to over and over and over. It's just a great song. And it sets up the whole premise of the immigrants and the millennial, and both looking for homes.
Right, absolutely.
Finding a home. And absolutely. We put that in quotations because it's home, which is great. So continue.
I will. My first job was when I was about 15 years old. And I worked at this tuxedo store. I only did it because it was the only way I could get my permit to drive when I was 15. And so I got this job, and I worked there for about a month or so. And they had me go polish a bunch of shoes one day. And I went, looked at the shoes, and I was like, man, this job sucks. So I quit the job. I don't know. And so I walked across the street to like a mall, you know, and I called my mom. My mom was like, so you quit? And my mother, God bless her, she came and picked me up, which was kind of shocking in hindsight. But that's the song. The song is not about my first job. It's about the immigrant's first job and setting down roots in America. And it's called My First Job. My first job, I was 17, sweeping kiln ashes at an airplane factory. For 10 hours a day, that was all they had for me. They'd give me $55, and that was more than I'd need. Sleep like an enchilada next to four other guys like me. We had a pound of rice and a couple dozen cans of beer. Yes, and all the rest went to providing for my family. Oh, and ain't that the American dream? Oh, and ain't that the American dream? Though it may not look like you've always seen, I said, God bless the American dream. Oh, God bless the American dream. My first job, when I was just 15, we're cleaning up chicken waste at the chicken factory. With 10 hours a day, that was all they had for me. Give me $55, and that was more than I need. To sleep like an enchilada next to four other guys like me. We had a pound of rice and a couple dozen cans of beef. Yes, and all the rest went to providing for my family. Oh, and ain't that the American dream? Yes, and ain't that the American dream? But though it may not look like you've always seen, God bless the American dream. Oh, God bless the American dream. Yes, and Father, help these weary hands, and bless these tired bones. And if I should die before I wake, take my soul and God bless my family. Yes, and God bless the American dream. Oh, and God bless the American dream. Though it may not look like you've always seen, I say, God bless the American dream. God
God bless the American dream. La 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 la. God bless the American dream. La 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 la. God bless the American dream.
Yeah, that's again a great song. Don't mean to interrupt, but hey, that one also it grabs you, and it's you know, the whole concept of building the wall that we're hearing so much about these days. That is that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
And your music, and the opposite of what they're talking about.
Absolutely.
And that's why this is just such an important and entertaining album.
Well, thank you. Yeah, which has been increasingly weird since this election cycle and the Paris terrorist attacks. All this talk about refugees and immigrants and. It's gotten even a little uncomfortable for me sometimes, I think.
Mm. Yeah, that's interesting. When you're standing on stage.
Yeah, right.
You're the one doing the singing.
Yeah, it's made me rethink it anyway. It's kind of changed the context a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
This next couple of songs sort of are I think these are the first two that I wrote. And I kind of wrote them as a single song, turned into two tracks. But these were the first ones that I wrote. I'm going to go back to the millennial kid story. I knew I wanted to make sort of a time piece for the record, a sort of time reference. And so this song is about experiencing 9/11 through the millennial perspective and kind of growing up in a world before 9/11 and then sort of becoming this young adult and leaving home as things were sort of chaotic and whatever they were after September 11th. But I wanted to write a song about September 11th. I didn't know exactly how to approach it because I didn't really feel like there's probably much that could be written that hadn't been written. And so this is a song that is a I like this song because it's mostly dialogue, and it's a conversation between this young kid and his father. It's called Winter 2001, and then we'll go directly into Born in the Wrong Time.
Where were you the day that JFK died? In a 10th grade classroom, passing a note to a girl, my father replied. It was winter 2001. It was cold. We were stuck inside. Nothing to do but sit in the kitchen and talk about what it was like the day that JFK died. And the loudspeaker crackled as the principal spoke and hummed like a funeral choir. The crackle was silent. And the silence was endless. And the teacher told us to close up our books, put away all our supplies. And everyone cried. Oh, I'll never forget the day JFK died. Summer of '02, the heat was heavier than usual, and I packed up my things and headed out on the interstate, seeking the great education expected in the millennial age. Weightless in the wind, a young man carried away. Got lost in the binary wreckage of the digital age. We found Kerouac days and White Album nights. We were bartering our consciousness for insights. We were sunbeams and the world was a tan. Starving for the light when the great revolution began. We were prime for the fight. We were born in the wrong time. Born in the wrong time. Oh, oh, oh. Born in the wrong time. Short and the war was on. Everything had changed. We stood in lines in the street sides. We sing about the changing of the times. We sing about them staying the same. We sing about politics and picking sides. We sang who really believes. We were young, and we were angry. We were sunbeams, and the world was a tan. Starving for the light when the great revolution began. We were prime for the fight. We were born in the wrong.
Luke Pruitt, Born in the Wrong Time. That is end of Act One, according to the CD. And I want to take a quick break. And when we come back, we'll have more. Luke Pruitt, live in the studio. We'll be back in just 2 minutes. It's Acoustic Breakfast on Radio Woodstock, and very special Acoustic Breakfast this morning. It is. We've got Luke Pruitt joining us live in the audience, and his band is here as well. And they are performing Home Part 2, an album that Luke wrote. When did this come out?
October of last year.
Yeah. October of last Barely year. New. And you're touring a bit. You were in Daryl's House Club last night.
I was. Open for Dawn of the Buffalo
last
night.
Yeah, very cool. And a crowded house, too.
It was packed. Yeah, it was great. It was a great crowd. A lot of fun. Everybody was dancing and all that good stuff. we had a good time, and then we had to leave kind of early so we could get up early.
And you could get here
and play this,
and we could give you some coffee. So Act Two on this album comes up, and the first song on here is called "Pray." Tell us about that.
I guess "Pray" is sort of a bridge. So 9/11, the 9/11 song is kind of this is sort of the aftermath, I guess. And both of these, and we'll do a song called "Stranger" after this one. That's sort of the immigrants' view of 9/11. So this song is sort of a bridging between the two characters, just sort of a plea for prayers, maybe, or a request for prayers, maybe. And this is called "Pray."
Would you care to pray for me, though our faith is weak? Sentiment of strength and hope could bring us to our feet. Waters strong and angry left me with no breath. Say for me a prayer to carry on my pilgrimage. We may go a separate way, or we may go the same. We may end up hand in hand, or miles away. Still our struggle somehow seems the same. Days of youthful wonder have slipped into the past, and in this darkened hour I've wandered from my path. We may go a separate way, or we may go the same. We may end up hand in hand, miles away. Still our struggle somehow seems the same. So would you care to pray for me? And I will pray for you.
So this next song is the the immigrant immigrant's perspective on September 11th terrorist attacks. When I was interviewing my friends, he said, you know, before 9/11, it was really pretty easy to get around and you know, not be not be noticed or you know, talked negatively to or whatever. And he said after 9/11, he sort of noticed the the change in mentality. People were, said it felt like they were a little more paranoid and a little more just scared, I think. And so this is that song. This is about being around people you're familiar with and feeling like a stranger. It's called Stranger.
Honest men turn to thieves in desperation. Friends, they are few and far between. The streets are filled with no one to be trusted. So I came uninvited to this place where a man can make a living out of nothing. Now I've made an honest living and I've made some friends among my neighbors. Now we all have seen the evil that a desperate man can bring. Crumbles our buildings, threatens our streets, turns our friends to enemies. And though each man is merely but a breath, fear consumes us in the sight of death. And death has shaped I'm a stranger here, yes, I'm a stranger, though familiar are the faces that I see. I've seen faces change when the heart is full of fear, smiling eyes turn to cold, distant stares. I am a stranger here. Children in the streets. I've watched them and wondered at an innocence I'd never known. I'm thankful for this place where liberty is born into a man. Now I mourn for my neighbors who fear without knowing. Desperate man can bring it. Crumbles our buildings, threatens our streets, turns our friends to enemies. And though each man is merely but a breath, fear consumes us in the sight of death. Death has shaped. I'm a stranger here, yes, I'm a stranger, though familiar are the faces that I see. I have seen faces change when the heart is full of fear, smiling eyes turned to cold and distant stare, and I am a stranger here.
The next song that you're going to do is one that I think most people can relate to, if they have siblings, I would think. Where did this one come from?
Yeah, this is kind of just a lighthearted note. I think I wrote it fairly quickly as I was kind of in the process of writing all these. These were two brothers that I was interviewing, and I grew up with two older brothers, and I guess it was kind of in the midst of all this pretty heavy discussion that we were having. The lighthearted teasing between brothers and that sort of thing kind of stuck with me, and so. You know, I am having two older brothers, and now I've got two little boys myself. So I felt this was a good tribute to the family notion in this record. So
it's called Brothers. There's a half pint of whiskey in the kitchen. We can stay up late if we need to. We can talk about Star Wars and World War II. Talk about love. Talk about truth. You can roam through the world and carry its weight on your shoulder. You can climb to the top till your body can take no more. Thank you.
that's what brothers are for.
That's right.
It's Acoustic Breakfast. We've got music from Luke Pruitt this morning, live in the studio. And we do appreciate you getting up quite so early. I know musicians aren't known for early risers, but we do appreciate you coming in and doing that for us on Acoustic Breakfast.
Well, I am certainly honored to be here and appreciate all the all the kind words. This is the only love song that made the record. I lived in Nashville, Tennessee for a long time, kind of kicking around there and writing songs every now and then. And I was visiting home. One week I had a couple of weddings. A couple of friends of mine were getting married a weekend apart, and so I went home and I was staying with my folks, and I went up to Fayetteville, Arkansas one day and went shopping for blue jeans, and I got some blue jeans in Fayetteville, Arkansas, and then 3 months later, I moved back to Fayetteville, and then 6 months later, I was married to the girl that sold me the blue jeans. So she had to make the record, and so this was that song. So this is called Because of You.
'cause of you. Everything has changed because of you.
A beautiful love song. And it fit right in.
Fits right in. I think that's a good spot for it. I wanted to keep a family structure theme in the record. I think that fit right in there. And this is sort of a follow-up to that.
Faces come and faces pass, but none of them have a name. And I've thrown my fate to the wind. Coast to coast I roam. Now I'm tired and I have done all I could do alone. So I'm gonna settle down in the heartland, build an American home, oh yeah. Said I'm gonna settle down in the heartland, build an American home, oh yeah. Said I'm gonna settle down in the heartland, build an American home. Oh, and God bless the American home. Yes, and God bless the American home. Though it may not look like you've always known, I said, God bless the American home. Oh, God bless the American home. God bless the American home. Though it may not look like you've always known, God bless the American home.
That one's called American Home. It's a great song. That ends Act 2. Act 3, we actually probably have time for two more songs.
Two more songs, okay.
What do you think?
Here's what I'm going to do. I'd like to play the other one from Part 1, Eric and Lily, that sort of gave me the idea to sort of kind of look at hometown from a different perspective. And this one has a little story to it.
Oh.
I'm going to do this one by myself, by the way. They were like, they were both looking at, what's
right,
he doing? Fort Smith, Arkansas, something people may not know about it, if you know anything about Fort Smith, Arkansas, is after the fall of Saigon in 1975, we got a lot of Vietnamese refugees in Fort Smith. And this song is, there's a lot of great Vietnamese food in Fort Smith, and this is about the owners of a little cafe that I've been eating at for years and years, and they've got a particularly interesting story that I wanted to tell. It's a little mom-pa joint. Their names are Eric and Lily, and whenever they were fleeing Saigon, they were boarding a helicopter to leave, and Eric was shot in the back of the neck, and had to board the helicopter and fly 30 something hours to the States, and spent 9 months in a hospital in Florida, I think, having multiple reconstructive surgeries on his jaw and stuff like that. So I was really looking for a specific song about Fort Smith, Arkansas, and this one sort of jumped out at me, and I knew if I didn't write it, probably nobody would. So this is called Eric and Lily.
Eric and Lily leased this old filling station November 1984. Lily's worked 10 hours a day in the kitchen, and Eric the banh mi, the green tea, the floor. Tiled in vinyl and dirty from time, from each muddy boot and each spill of fur. Two kids through school on the cash-only dive, American Ma and Pa. From gravity's fall on a Saigon home to this any American town. Stories are told all over the country, though most of them ain't written down. So if you don't listen, you're likely to miss them, and they won't always be around. Eric was shot in the back of the neck as he boarded a chopper to flee the land he was born, with Lily beside him, to a faraway hospital, just refugees. 9 months of surgery, 40 years sore, and he never could talk like he once did. But I hear his story in the center of the tea, and when he takes my order and thanks me. From gravity's fall on a Saigon home to this any American town. Stories are told all over the country, though most of them ain't written down. So if you don't listen, you're likely to miss them, and they won't always be around. I go in the crowd thins about two or three as Eric cleans up the last tables. And she brings their meals and they sit together, and I'm in the corner, the news on TV. Some story about divide and I split Constitution, but I was listening to them speak Vietnamese. The whole conversation, the decay of a nation, brings me back to these refugees, oh, refugees. The whole conversation, the decay of a nation, brings me back to these refugees. From gravity's fall on a Saigon home to this any American town. Stories are told all over the country, though most of them ain't written down. So if you don't listen, you're likely to miss them, and they won't always be around. Said if you don't listen, you're likely to miss them, and they won't always be around.
And that was from Home Part One. Well, it's a pleasure having you here, and I thank you for coming all the way up from home.
Yeah. It was a long way, but it's good to be here. This is two kinds of people.
Got a station, and you got to choose. You know they're both kind of crazy from the other point of view. But if you don't choose one, they'll just choose one for you. 'Cause in the age of information, can't help but laugh at the human race. 'Cause we got satellites in space orbiting this place, mapping every meter of this rock we're on. Still we haven't found a way to get along. Kinds of people in the world. Oh, it's true. You know, I heard it on the news. So get mad, get scared. That's what you're supposed to do. Take up arms and pick a side. No better way to get along. 'Cause we're right, and we know somebody's got to be. There's two kinds of people in the world. Oh, it's true. You know I heard it on the news. It's in the age of information. I can't help but laugh at the human. Satellites in space orbiting this place, mapping every meter of this rock we're on. Still we haven't found a way to get along. 'Cause there's two kinds of people in the world. Oh, it's true. You know I heard it on the news.
That's Luke Pruitt, and the album is called Home Part 2. Thank you very much for coming in early this morning and doing this for us. We really appreciate it.
Well, thank you for having me. We're all glad to be here. It's been a long trip and an early morning, but we're glad to be here.
And when your next novella is done, you'll come back and do it again.
Absolutely will.
All right,
absolutely
thanks very much.
And you don't have to tell me.